Today, we are going to create a super simple ring. Let's practice some basic techniques and get some quick successes. This video is the first lesson of my new class on Skillshare, Blender 3D Geometry, Complex Patterns Made Easy. Join me in this class and get both the dragon scale texture and the basic ring as a download to jump right into giving our models some cool 3D printable textures. You can also ask me questions and get feedback for your projects. Let's go! Let's create a very basic ring band without any bells and whistles. Shift A for adding a torus. Then bring down the major and minor segment count, as this is far too detailed for our purposes. It would make editing this thing significantly harder. And we need this straightforward for now. Let's give it 8 to 12 major segments and 6 minor segments. You can now use the major and minor radius to change the size, but we will, and you can, adjust this anyways later still, so this is optional. Here you see me roughly bringing this to a realistic ring size. If you like, you can enable the pie menu for switching modes in the preferences. Then you can choose between all modes when switching. In edit mode, we grab the outer face rings to elongate the shape along Z. Hover over the edge in between vertices that you want to select. Press Alt and click. To select the next edge row, hold Shift and Alt click in the same way on the other side to add to the selection. Use S and Z to elongate along Z. Add a subdivision surface modifier, either in the modifier tab or just press Ctrl-2 for two subdivisions. A little something about these extra modifier buttons on the right. These come from the internal add-on modifier tools. Just search for them under Edit, Preferences, and Add-ons. Then we scale the outer of these edges in a bit with Shift Z to give the whole ring a more rounded off shape. Now let's give the shape a few more control points by adding two more edge rings around the outer ring band with Ctrl R, which are then scaled along Z so that we have a basis for our outer rims of the ring band. Select those newly created edge rings by holding Shift plus Alt and then clicking on each of those rings, one after the other. Press E for Extrude. Then S to scale, after that Shift Z to only scale in the horizontal axes. Move your mouse to pull them out a bit to form those nice rims around your ring. Switch to Edge Select mode with 2 on your num row and then select these edge rings. The edges of these newly created rims can be creased to keep them sharp. Fully crease with Shift E and 1. Of course, you can always experiment with creasing different edges to see if you like the effect. I decided to get rid of the crease of the outer rim in the item tab of the end menu by just setting the mean crease for these edges to 0. But in any case, we can adjust these details later still, so don't fuss about it. I will also continue to play around with creasing during this class. I add another 2 edge rows. These 2 new edges help us now to reduce the little kink in the center of the ring band. For this, we just scale the center edge ring slightly down. I also rotated the ring by 90 degrees in X, just to have a little bit better view and control. Feel free to adjust the shape of your ring band in any way you like, but keep it simple. This project is about the texturing, not the basic shape modeling. One more tip towards creating this ring true to your desired ring size. You can use either the JewelCraft add-on are simply a curved circle. You may find a ring size table in the resources so that you can calculate what your radius should be for the desired ring size. With the add-on, you have the advantage that it allows you to directly choose a ring size instead of having to calculate it and then use the radius as a value. If you add a size curve while having the ring selected, a curve modifier gets added to your ring and it gets squished into a Pringles shape. Just delete the curve modifier again to get rid of this effect. Now you can rename the size curve to your ring size so that you know what it is there for. And finally, you can scale the ring so that it matches the ring size. I will show it to you in the full viewport mode. You can access this with Ctrl+Alt+Q and also get out of it. You can either scale in all three dimensions to keep the aspect ratio, or to avoid making it much broader, you could scale while excluding Y with the shortcut Shift+Y. Also, check the ring band thickness. A value between 1.8 and 3 mm usually works well for such a ring. But this is also a matter of 3D printing and design experience, and of course, a lot of trial and error. Did you know that you can now book one-on-one sessions directly with me? Many people already have brought their 3D dreams to reality. Just a few examples are designing a signet ring for her husband, creating an engagement ring for his fiancée, building a coin ring, a personalized pendant, and so much more. Simply book a free slot in my calendar.